Hello, everybody. Welcome into our RP Funding Theater. I'm Jana from XL 1067, and we're really excited that you guys could take some time out of your day to kind of come into our den here, where we get to meet some pretty cool artists that come through Orlando. Now, you guys have got to be a little delicate for Kat. She was actually performing at the Parliament House last night at about 1 o'clock in the morning, so she's fresh as a daisy for us. So please make some noise for Kat Graham. Hello. Welcome to Orlando and our RP Funding Theater.
Hi, guys. How are you?
You are a very busy girl.
I know.
I followed along on your Twitter last night from Parliament House in the middle of the night to Tampa this morning to nonstop, and now you're here with us, so hello.
Thank you. I'm on an hour of sleep, so I just space out.
You're kind of used to that, aren't you?
A little bit.
Well, let's go ahead and wake you up then, because I have a feeling like moving and singing and dancing, that always helps me out.
My third show of the day, we're going to do it. You know what's so funny? These are like people that, like, you know, you guys won, right? This is like a thing that you guys won.
Yeah.
This is like one of my last shows here in Florida, and I have this thing where I'm like really close to all of my fans. That's why I insist on doing meet and greets and stuff like that. Would it be okay if I have them a little closer to me? Like, you guys, do you mind standing up and like coming to the front so I could like feel, is that okay?
Well, Kat wants,
they're like, there's
Kat gets.
Chairs.
She's like, everybody stand up.
Is that okay?
Of course.
I get to see you guys and remember you and feel you, and it makes such a difference for me as a performer. I love it. Oh, you got a Vampire Diary shirt. So cute. Okay, so I'm going to do two songs for you guys. The first one is off of my EP, Against the Wall, and the song is called Heart Killer, and then I'm going to do Graffiti for you guys. So I hope you like it. I am here just for you, so I hope you like it. Okay. Ready.
Willa, stone cold killer, hit it and quitter, baby. No hot stiller, sex stiller, don't pull the trigger, baby. No, you're never gonna take me out, never, never gonna take me out. You should've known better, if you go getter, you'll end up in flames, flames. Oh, oh, there you go, gun in your holster, ready to blow. Oh, oh, there you go, hunting me down like an animal. Oh, oh, there you go. Uh-oh, there you go. Uh-oh, there you go. There you go, there you go. I don't wanna be your, see you, hear you, you're a whore killer. I don't wanna feel you, can't be near you, you're a whore killer. A murderer, serial lover. I don't wanna be your, see you, hear you, you're a whore killer. You're a whore killer.
Fat liar, pants on fire, stupid ain't nothing but a game, game. Preaching to the choir, bullets keep flying, bet you look good in red, red.
No, you're never gonna take me out, never, never gonna take me out.
You should've known better, if you go getter, you'll end up in flames, flames.
Uh-oh, there you go, gun in your holster, ready to blow. Uh-oh, there you go, hunting me down like an animal. Uh-oh, there you go. Oh, there you go. Oh, oh, there you go. There you go. There you go. I don't wanna be your, see ya, hear ya, you're a whore killer. I don't wanna feel ya, can't be near ya, you're a whore killer. A murderer, serial lover. I don't wanna be your, see ya, hear ya, you're a whore killer. You're a whore killer. Chalk lines on the floor. If I let you in, I'll never become victim to your touch. Damn, it's fire, love, love, love.
RP Funding Theater here with XL 106.7.
Where are you coming from? There you are. You're back there.
I'm coming through. I was like hanging in the back watching the video feed because I'm short.
How awesome are they?
They're the coolest, by
the
way.
They're the coolest.
We love having people in here because they do kind of get a different perspective on the artist, and especially with you because you got a lot going on with the whole Triple Threat thing. Obviously, some people know you from the TV show.
Right. But, a couple of Vampire Diaries fans in here.
But you've been at it for a really, really long time. I mean, you've been doing this since you were a kid.
A long time.
I mean, I saw it was like award shows, and then you did the whole dancing. Clearly, dancing is a very big part of what you're doing.
Well, not on carpet, but...
in usually, high heels. Yeah. But as an audio nerd that I am, I really kind of love the fact that you actually went out and got educated.
Well, yeah, because like I think I started... How old are you? I started DJing when I was like 12, 13. And then like when I was a year older than her, mm-hmm. I started engineering.
Yeah, she actually went to school and got her degree in audio engineering. I don't know if you guys knew that or not, but you could put her down in front of a Pro Tools machine and she could... really do some pretty wicked stuff with audio, which I love.
Thank you. It's kind of nerdy.
It's awesome nerdy, though. Woo-hoo! The first time I sit down in front of that computer and I saw what you could do with sound, I was like, hooked. I mean, yeah, being on the air is fun, but getting in front of like all of that audio equipment and getting to make music and getting to make noise, I thought that was the best part.
Well, I just feel like a lot of my fans, and I don't know if it's just me or if they're just it's just fans of people that are fans of different artists, but a lot of my fans mm-hmm. are either like amazing artists or like writers or
creative.
They're very creative, so they really appreciate it. And like especially like young people today are so immensely creative and so brilliant, especially with all like different arts and fan art and stuff mm-hmm. like that. So and they're also like they maybe want to be singers and they're inspired by me. So if they know like, oh, Kat started from scratch, like she didn't know anyone. She didn't have a famous relative.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Didn't have Justin Bieber making videos and putting it up on YouTube of your songs.
Yeah, and I think like that's the way the world is now, and they really appreciate it more than ever. You know, so it mm-hmm. feels good to be able to like perform to kids that do that too and are like, you know, because I kind of started a little bit on YouTube, but then I was like simultaneously on this like massive TV show.
Right.
But then I was still also making like little, you know, crummy YouTube videos and then they were getting attention, but then I was still on this huge TV show and then all of a sudden the two worlds went
Yeah, they really did. You got a lot of big names behind you, and that's really going to make you guys feel good about what you're doing and putting out there, because you could very easily just kind of hang out in the trailer at the TV set and just do your thing. But you're out here actually doing this, hanging out with your fans and performing.
Oh, this is like the best part, the fact that I get to like see you guys, because like I don't know when I would be able to see you, because of like between mm-hmm. like the touring and then the shooting schedule and then recording, it's like this is really why I'm out here. Like my favorite shows that I've done have been with people that are actually like I get to meet and they're my fans, and then I meet the same ones again and that we're friends and we share stories and they're part of this journey, you know, and it like reminds me like, wow, like this is why I'm a performer. Like this is all I care about doing is performing. So it's great. I can't thank you guys enough for like taking out this time to like come and hang out with me. It's such a great feeling.
Speaking of performing, you can't turn on the internet, you can't turn on the radio without hearing your new song, which is really cool.
Yeah, I'm
going to
do it for you guys.
It's stuck in my head now.
I'm going to do it for you guys. Yeah,
excellent.
No, it's a really fun song. I wanted it to be like dance heavy because mm-hmm. a lot of people didn't know that I'm like a dancer, and I wanted it to be like street, and I wanted it to be fun. Mm-hmm. I wanted it to be young and stuff like that. So
and
good.
Catchy. And now it's so vernacular. It's so
crazy.
I love it. You guys make some noise for Kat Graham. Wake her up, yeah?
You're so
here
awesome.
She is in our RP Funding Theater. Take it away.
Okay, this is my song, Put Your Graffiti on Me.
Denim jean jacket, pink chucks, and a mini skirt. Your bad habit, throw me up against the wall first. I'll take advantage of you. Take up this bottle of
Come on in.
Put your graffiti on me. Put your graffiti on me. Put your graffiti on me.
Tag me.
Put your name on it. 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 on it. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name. Cotton candy lollipop, sticky like a post-it. You don't need to drama, huh? You already own it. I'll take advantage of you. Drink up this bottle and yeah.
You know it? You're supposed to say tag me.
Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your
treat me like concrete under your feet. I'll be your canvas incomplete. Your paper doll, your alley wall in graffiti.
Put your graffiti on me. Put your graffiti on me. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name.
That's my show. I love you guys. So yeah. That's my show.
Kat Graham. Oh, that's good stuff.
I don't know where to go. I want to just jump into the sea of you,
pretty
but I have to stay
right?
back here.
Now, not only can they obviously see you on TV and all that fun stuff too, but your music's out there now.
It's out there finally. We did this EP. Mm-hmm. Against the Wall. At first, just started out kind of with Put Your Graffiti on Me, but I have like, or is oh, okay.
If you wanted to put your water down, I know how hard it is to juggle with a couple of hands.
Look at that.
Yay. So the EP is out now, which is really cool.
The EP's out. You know, when you record like, because I literally have over 40 songs. Now
you really have something against free time, don't you?
So much free time. I'm always tired.
So 5 songs are out.
I think only 4 are out.
Oh, that's my bad. That's 4, my bad.
4 on the EP.
Because with EPs, you never know. Which I think is kind of cool. You don't have to put out full albums anymore. You can put your music out as you're ready to put it out.
I know. It's the labels like they just want people to get familiar with like a few songs first, and then people want to hear more and stuff. I mean, like me, I'm just like, let's put out as much as possible. I want everyone to hear my music. I want to hear what I've been working on. Like, and they're like, you need to calm down.
Yeah, are you more comfortable on set or in studio?
Well, I'm comfortable in both. When I'm on set, I'm like with my friends. Like mm-hmm. these girls are my friends, and these guys are people I've been with for years now. And we're going into like season 4, so
cool.
I know it's crazy.
That's great.
So it's different, but I'm kind of in a more controlled mm-hmm. atmosphere. And then when we're in the studio, we're pretty goofy. Like, I mean, we're a little goofy on Vampire Diaries, but it's so, like, serious and there's life and death. That you can't really be, like, do cartwheels and goof around and, you know, do, like, what I am usually, like, just a complete prankster.
Well, Buffy the Vampire Slayer got to do a musical episode.
Oh, my gosh. I really hope we don't do a musical episode of Vampire Diaries.
That would be bad.
I hope that we never do one. I hope to God. No, and then, like, you know, when I'm in the studio, like, mm-hmm. I'm either, like, controlling it or, you know, I'm writing it or I'm controlling the environment because it's my music
right.
and it's my project. So it's just different.
But sometimes from that goofiness comes some really cool ideas.
Oh, yeah. Like, you have to be, like, really be able to be free and stuff. So, like, mm-hmm. like before I come out, like, I can always get, like, really, really nervous. But then I'm like, well, let me just get out all my sillies. So like when people are like, and coming up, Cat Graham, and I'm just like back there doing stupid moves and just like getting all my sillies out, and people probably think I'm just like really like cool and stuff, but I'm actually doing really stupid things back there to get it all out of my system so that I don't feel like I have to like hold back in front of you guys, because I don't know when I'm going to get to see you guys again. I don't know if this is the only time you'll ever get to see me perform, so you want to make it like the best for them, you know?
You got to get your sillies out.
You have to. I encourage everyone to get their sillies out. Even like before a date. Like if you're going on a date or you're going to like a show or you're going to meet like your favorite celebrity, like go into a corner and get your sillies out. It makes the world of a difference.
Scream it out in the car. Yeah. Do what you know what? I do something kind of similar to that is I will crank up my stereo as loud as I can in my car, and I will just sing my freaking head off before I have to come into work or go on stage at Red Hot and Boom tomorrow or anything like that. Like I will sing at the top of my lungs just to
get it out. For me, I like get like physically nervous, like all my like, you know, get the jitters.
You're still
nervous? I have to move. Well, I mean, not after I get my sillies out, no. But before then, if I'm like overthinking something, or even like if I have like a really hard scene, that's like gonna take a lot out of me. I'm just like, you know, get it all.
Gotta twit pick that out sometime. Yeah. Speaking of the Twitter, that's you, right? That's not anybody other than you.
No, it's me. Like,
so when they tweet you later and talk about how cool it was to meet you and get your pictures and all
that
stuff.
That's why it's like spurts. Like I try and answer all the fans, but I literally do spurts. So I do like 30 minutes of following a day, and then I just do as many in between as possible, and I try and remember people. It's hard. I try and follow as many of my fans as possible because I want to see what they like and what they're into.
Well, you guys have a homework assignment. You have to tweet out your pictures that you're about to take with
Kat,
okay?
We should do like a hashtag thing so I'm able to find them. Ah. So like hashtag...
XLCat.
Hashtag XLCat.
Deal?
So that way I can see it, because else I don't know if I'd be able to see it, and I could just like retweet you or whatever.
I'll hashtag it to you now while you're hanging out with them, signing autographs and taking pictures.
My phone's in there.
And then it'll be there.
Okay.
And we'll make sure the other Kat.
Kat Collins!
In the back
Shout out
of the
to
room.
Kat Collins!
It's double Kats. You guys don't know. The brain's back there. That's
He's the brains.
Kat.
She's I'm
the
just
beauty.
The performer.
And the creativity.
He's the brains.
And thank you so much for coming here and doing this
for us. Thank you guys
for
having me.
Really
this was like one of my favorite things I've gotten to do on tour. It's so intimate and like so awesome. Just such great people and good energy in here. It's made
Well, we're going to give you a second to have some more water and catch your breath. We get everybody all
to fix my hair so I don't look crazy in your photos. That's what it is with it really.
We're going to hang out with her a little bit longer. Is that cool?
Yay.
All right, perfect. All right, crank up the music. We'll bring Kat right out in a second.